Scientists' crazy new discovery on Proxima B. Hi everyone, welcome to our channel Space Light. Since we launched telescopes strong enough to detect exoplanets into space, the cosmos has been opening up to us like a big box of mysteries. Scientists, including those hired by NASA, have spent a great deal of time examining the Proxima exoplanet. Where does it leave us in terms of knowledge about this amazing world? Are there any living things? Was it NASA's study of Proxima B to learn more about its mysteries? The discovery of a new planet was announced less than 6 years ago. This planet, Proxima Centauri B, or simply Proxima B, is an exoplanet since it is located beyond the solar system. Astronomers have discovered many Earth-sized exoplanets in the last few years. Some of these stars are in the habitable zone, which means that they have temperatures that might support the presence of liquid water on their surfaces in some form. Proxima Centauri B's sun is approximately 4.2 light years distant from our own sun, making it an exciting target for astronomers. An astronomical team led by Guillaume Anglada Escud discovered Proxima B in the Pale Red Dot project. Doppler spectroscopy, or the radial velocity method, was used to establish its presence in the ESO 3.6-meter telescope utilizing the High-Accuracy Radial Velocity Planet Searcher, or HARPS, spectrograph. The spectra of stars are examined for evidence of wobble. The star moves closer and further away from Earth over time. This is created by the gravitational impact of planets that circle the lead, the extent of which is used to deduce the mass of the planets. Astronomers have estimated the group of Proxima B to be as low as 1.24 Earth's masses and as high as 2.06 Earth masses. Further confirmation of Proxima B's existence will be made in 2020 using the Very Large Telescope VLT of the European Southern Observatory (ESO) and its Aschel spectrograph for rocky extrasolar planet and stable spectroscopic observations as PRESO. For a star like Proxima Centauri, a low-mass and less luminous M-type or red dwarf star, the transit method could not be used to find exoplanets. At 1.17 Earth masses, Proxima Centauri B resembles Earth in size and mass. To put that into perspective, Earth takes 365 days to complete one of orbit of its sun, whereas this planet does it in just 11.2 days. To put it another way, it's as near to its star as the sun is to us. However, because it is a red dwarf, a much smaller and colder star than our own, its orbit does fall within Proxima Centauri's habitable zone. Proxima Centauri B receives nearly the same amount of solar radiation from its star as does Earth. This is rather remarkable. This suggests that the surface of Proxima Centauri B may be wet. Habitability, 4x worlds is still a mystery, but this one maybe. The presence or absence of water, the makeup of the planet and its atmosphere, and the radiation from the sun are just a few of the numerous aspects that determine whether or not a planet is habitable. In this video, you'll learn how flares from red stars like Proxima Centauri complicate the question of whether red dwarf exoplanets are habitable. When astronomers first discovered this exoplanet in 2016, they set out to see if it may become home to life. Even though it was located in the star's habitable zone, certain studies quickly threw doubt on the possibility of extraterrestrial life. As a result, scientists have disagreed about whether life may exist on Proxima B. According to all of these studies, there is no way to know until astronomers study the atmosphere of Proxima B as it passes in front of or transits its host star. Astronomers from the University of Chicago conducted a new NASA-funded study and concluded that this is a highly implausible scenario. Emily A. Gilbert, a graduate student in the University of Chicago's Department of Astronomy and Astrophysics, conducted the research that outlines their results. Adler Planetarium, University of Maryland Center for Space Science and Technology, and NASA's Goddard Space Flight Center experts were among those who attended her presentation. Although life may exist in Proxima B, a major obstacle will be make it possible. It's referred to as space weather. For those who live on the surface of the Earth, the weather is a natural topic of conversation. The weather on other planets and moons with atmospheres can also come to mind if you're familiar with such environments. However, none of it has anything to do with space weather. This weather starts in the stars, including our sun, and penetrates the surrounding universe. During flares on the sun or other celebrities, ionizing radiation is emitted. Any life forms on faraway planets might be killed by radiation. According to scientists, red dwarf stars, which have more frequent flares than our own sun, are particularly susceptible to this. Red dwarf stars like Proxima Centauri may be extremely volatile. Proxima's space weather was studied by astronomers at the University of Sydney using radio waves. At least two planets circle this closest neighbor of our sun. Both Proxima Centauri B and C are nearly as large as our own planet. Still, there is a third, Proxima Centauri D. There's a good chance Proxima Centauri B, which circles its star in the star's habitable zone, has liquid water on its surface. This is not a sign of life if you nod your head in agreement. there is little hope for life on the planets around stars like Proxima based on the observations of flares, since Proxima Centauri B is so near to its parent star, it experiences frequent bursts of ionizing radiation. The existence of an exoplanet in the habitable zone does not always imply that it can support life. Exactly like Proxima B in comparison to Mercury, the habitable zone of Proxima Centauri is significantly closer to the star than Mercury is to our Sun. According to research, this puts the planets very sensitive to hazardous ionizing radiation, which might essentially sterilize the planets. Do not forget about coronal mass ejection events, in which our Sun frequently discharges hot clouds of ionized particles. Our habitable zone, which is far from the Sun's surface, is insulated from these occurrences because the Sun is hotter than Proxima Centauri and other red dwarf stars, thus this radiation doesn't affect us as much. In addition, the Earth's magnetic field shelters us from these powerful solar plasma explosions. With the outcome of researching the space weather around Proxima Centauri, scientists may presume that all red dwarf stars are not the friendliest sites for life. Distance from the star, the strength of the planet's magnetic field, and other variables might play a role here. Relative to their size, certain red dwarfs are presumably more active than others. As a result, it's impossible to generalize the circumstances surrounding red dwarfs. Scientists have also tried to figure out what the Earth might look like if it were orbiting Proxima Centauri to investigate the possibilities of life there better. They used modeling to get a sense of how things will play out. Our discussion of livable zones returns. A planet in the habitable zone where water may pool on its surface does not always guarantee a viable place to live. If water exists on the planets or whether an atmosphere can survive in that orbit is not considered. Life as we know it relies also on atmospheres for climate management, water-friendly surface pressure, protection from dangerous space weather, and the storage of life's chemical building components. Proxima B's atmosphere, magnetic field, and gravity were modeled using Earth's atmosphere, magnetic field, and gravity. Chandra X-ray observatory measurements also computed the average amount of radiation produced by Proxima Centauri. Based on these facts, their model mimics the effects of the host star's high radiation and frequent flaring on the exoplanet's atmosphere based on these facts. High-energy ultraviolet light ionizes atmospheric gases, knocking off electrons and creating a swath of electrically charged particles when it hits an active red dwarf star like Proxima Centauri's. The freshly produced electrons can quickly escape the planet's gravitational pull and speed out of the atmosphere in this process. More negatively charged electrons leave the atmosphere with a large charge separation that draws positively charged ions out into space. This is due to the law of attraction opposite charges attract. The Sun's UV radiation bombards Proxima B by hundreds of times its level on Earth and the habitable zone of Proxima Centauri. There is enough energy in that radiation to tear away hydrogen and heavier atoms like oxygen and nitrogen over time. According to the model, our atmosphere is being drained 10,000 times quicker than on Earth because of Proxima Centauri's strong radiation. The scientists looked at two other variables that worsen atmospheric loss to understand better how the process might differ. The thermosphere, the middle layer of it, the atmosphere, was the first thing they looked at since it is the most constant temperature. They discovered that air escape rises as the atmosphere warms up from increased solar radiation. If you believe that there is life in Proxima B, please share your thoughts in the comments area below. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, share, like, and comment today. See you in the next video.